ripping off Medicare, possessing child pornography, even hiring a hitman to kill someone. They are among the most serious criminal accusations, and believe it or not, they were all lodged against Ohio doctors.
So why, in many cases, were those doctors still able to practice medicine after their arrest? 9 News anchor Lance Berry with an exclusive 9 News investigation tonight.
You'll likely be shocked to find out that under Ohio law, a felony criminal conviction does not mean a doctor will lose his medical license. Instead, the state's medical board decides that independently. And in some cases, the punishment can be as little as just a reprimand, with the doctor keeping his license and his ability to treat you. They grabbed national headlines. Twin Butler County pediatricians, Drs. Mark and Scott Blankenberg, convicted of pandering sexually oriented material involving minors and drug charges. And in 2007, Mark was also found to have child porn on his home computer. Both sent off to state prison in 2010. But it was months later that their medical licenses were finally revoked by the state, and 3 full years after the allegations first surfaced.
The motto of a doctor is do no harm, right? The motto of the state medical board, I would assume, could be we will do no harm.
Butler County Prosecutor Michael Moser's office prosecuted the Blankenbergs. However, he was not in office at the time, and it doesn't appear that the office was to blame for the delay in any licenses being yanked. So we teamed up with our sister station in Cleveland to get answers about the delays from the very people who are responsible for those medical licenses, the state medical board.
It's hard for me to believe that investigators armed with 2,500 pornographic images on a pediatrician's computer in 2007,
right,
would not have immediately picked up the phone.
Here's the difference.
Call the medical board. I mean, don't you think they do that?
Well, and again, if the question is when we were contacted, I mean, we can find out when that was.
However, detectives who worked the Blankenberg cases say the medical board was informed from the beginning.
He moved on to tell me how beautiful I was and that he was in love with me.
And he's in love with you.
He said, I love you.
Rusty Hardin is talking about Dr. Shafiq Ahmad, a Cleveland area doctor. Other accusations against Ahmad on file with the state include pressing his pelvic area against a woman's thigh, groping another's breasts, and attempting to kiss a patient with his tongue. All over an 8-year span and 13 allegations in total. But then in 2009, Ahmad was accused of hiring a hitman to kill his wife. The board didn't act until 4 months after that arrest, instead giving the doctor a hearing. It was just this past July the board finally yanked Ahmad's license after his conviction. Now, as for those sexual misconduct hearings, they never happened.
We're governed by the laws of Ohio, and we are limited in that which we can do. An allegation is not enough for us to take an action on based upon someone's license.
Just how often does this happen? More than you'll likely care to think. Take a look for yourself. State medical boards have failed to discipline 55% of the nation's doctors who either lost their clinical privileges or had them restricted. In Kentucky, that number was 38%, Ohio, 56%, and Indiana, 73%. Other examples we found include doctors convicted of stealing hundreds of thousands of dollars from Medicare. Other accusations that the board says are always taken seriously, but also acted on with care.
This is high stakes. This is very serious stuff. We get some very high-powered attorneys coming in here arguing for folks on behalf of them and their license. We can't afford to be wrong, because if we're wrong, that person not just keeps their license, but they continue doing what they're doing.
A potentially positive change to come from all of this, Moser says he's learned that the state is now committed to faster action in some of the worst cases in the future.
They now have adopted a faster track for those types of cases. They're not going to use that in every case. They're going to use it in the most serious cases.
The worst thing we could do is hurry up to the finish to proceed without evidence.
Certainly, if it comes on my radar, if I get a hit on my radar, it goes to the state medical board. That's just clear.
So your office is going to do that?
I will always do that.
The state medical board oversees some 60,000 health professionals and receives about 4,000 complaints each year. But believe it or not, there are only 20 statewide inspectors for all of those complaints. For much more on this story, you'll find it on WCPO.com.
Barry reporting for us. Thanks, Lance.